Okay, so let's quickly recap. We had a serial version of the code that did everything in a single thread. Trivial to write that code, zero parallelism, and pretty terrible performance. Then we had a parallel per row version of the code that was also pretty simple to write and assigned one thread per row and a single thread block. Again, did not get great performance, although a huge improvement, factor of about 100. Then in the third version, we extracted pretty much all the parallelism that the problem has to offer and assigned one thread per element of the matrix. So we did this transpose operation now in sort of massive parallel, and now we got, you know, quite a bit better performance. Remember that all of this is happening in the context of APOD: analyze, parallelize, optimize, and deploy. And this is actually might be fast enough that you're ready to deploy it, right? So we started by looking at analyzing the code and deciding that this function of transposing a matrix needed to be sped up. We started exploring ways to parallelize it, and this might be fast enough. This is already a place where you ought to look at this and say, is this the bottleneck anymore? Is speeding this up going to make a big difference to my application? If not, then deploy. If so, then we can start thinking about optimizing it. And that was the next thing we did. We looked at the performance here. We saw that we were getting pretty poor DRAM utilization, and we diagnosed that the problem must be that our global stores were getting bad coalescing. In other words, when we were writing the output matrix, we were getting bad coalescing in those accesses to global memory. So to fix that, we came up with a tiled version of our code, where each thread block is responsible for reading a tile of the input matrix, transposing it, and writing that transpose matrix to its location in the output matrix, and it can perform these reads and writes in a coalesced fashion. We did this in blocks of 32 by 32 tiles and got excellent coalescing. This improved our speed a little bit, but we're still not getting great DRAM utilization. So we looked into why. So when we thought a little bit more about why we wouldn't have taken a great improvement in bandwidth, we concluded we probably had too many threads waiting at barriers. So we improved that by shrinking the tile size. Experimenting with different tile sizes led us to conclude that a 16 by 16 thread block writing into a 16 by 16 tile in shared memory struck a good balance between achieving coalesced reads and writes to memory and not spending too much time waiting at barriers.